So I got two identical UTVs here, both Yamaha Rhinos with the 660cc engine option. One of them on tracks and the other one on tires. The plan is to just, we got about a foot of snow and we're gonna just drive around in the snow and see how the tracks versus tires perform. So as far as tires, this one has some pretty nice tires on it, 28-inch Maxxillas they are. As far as tracks, I don't know, he's got some Kimpex tracks. I bought these used. Let's see how much higher up the tracks put this. Alright, let's just alright, so let's just try going up some hills and stuff and see what happens.
Thank you.
that this may not break through ice. It's easy. I forget how deep this is though.
Fine.
Oh, you don't think it's gonna break? Like that's barely making it. It's making it.
Look at him when he tries to catch a pulse though. It's hilarious.
Thank you. like you're on top of these rocks, and
yeah.
You know, I guess the tires bite on that better.
That was a good test though. That
yeah.
Was,
well, because it plus it being narrow too, and it's everything's kind of leaning at you.
My thought would be these ain't worth it because this.
Yeah, so
this
far that is doing sort of better.
I wonder if I think like I feel like these are better for breaking snow though.
I bet you if the snow is really deep.
Yeah.
That would work better.
Because you got more ground clearance too. It does.
Yeah. This thing, it's way faster in these two, but just to run this around in the snow. This thing's got so much power, it can just kind of do anything. Misusing the thing, but you know, threw a track off there. Look at that. Cody, what do you think? Think it's easier to fix this where the tools are? I think so. I'm noticing the track frame here. Look at that, that's kind of bent looking. See how it's like twisted? I don't know if I did that. I might have. I think I got it though. Look at that. Oh, am I bending something wrong? All right, it's actually on everywhere. Just right here is off. Alright, so that's fixed. Let's all the snow kind of melted. This was only like 3 days later that came off. So the snow's a drop different today, but let's try to recreate that same scenario with the wheeled rhino. Go back up over these logs. wasn't easy going, but you know, no tracks fell off or anything. So, you know, I think it's supposed to sound like that. This is how I'm going to handle this. Since this doesn't really have to do with tracks versus tires, I mean, it kind of does. I'll make the clutch repair on this a separate video. I'm pretty sure it kind of got a little bit, I don't think it liked getting stuck in that water. Alright, we got some new snow here. Just got a call on the phone saying a side-by-side fell through some ice somewhere, so we're gonna go try to get it out. Does this run?
I haven't tried it since last night.
Oh, it's been here overnight?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you're pretty stuck. That's a lot deeper than it looks. I mean, this only...
The thing is, this was covered with snow.
Really?
And I was just gonna go right through here and it just sunk the front.
Certainly did. All right, let's... All right, so I just finished fixing the transmission on this one. It ended up getting half of the clutch, one-way bearing, an axle, and a muffler. And I don't know how long that axle was broken. This may have been three-wheel drive for a good section of this video. So either three-wheel drive if the front diff is locked, or two-wheel drive if you're in four-wheel drive, because it's an open diff, and it would just be spinning that broken axle. All right, when I fixed this track, I noticed how bent this axle shaft was. Look how much fatter this new one is. I mean, the old one didn't have this. Maybe that was just for shipping. That's it. See that? Now that won't come off of there. Waiting for like 3 feet of snow to come, and now it's February and it's getting warm out. So let's bring these up the mountain while there's still a lot of snow up there, just in case we don't get any more, right? So coming up the hill, the snow gets a lot deeper. The condition stays warm out, so the snow is packy. need like flotation in the snow, that's the way to do it. There's no way the wheels would be anywhere near up here. Look at the nice packed down path it leaves. See, now that's easy to like walk on. Alright, well, I think this picture right here pretty much sums it up. So, tracks are better when there is a lot of snow. Especially this packy snow where it just kind of stays on top of it. It actually lays out like a nice track. The wheel machine just sinks and gets stuck in it. Dude, check out how we groomed this. Look at that. There's a lot of snow here, but it's like, I think we could stay on top of it now. Cruise control. Cody's got like a dead animal over there. What is this? Is that something a lab would be excited in? Did you dig that up? Is that something you want in your mouth? What we got? A hoof? Delicious. Delicious. Yep, you're so excited to have that. Here's the team right here doing a little volunteer work for the snowmobile club. Got the groomer, and then I'm gonna be packing.
down this rock as a surprise. Working pretty good, huh?
Yeah, you know, I'm driving as fast as I can. Normally I just do a first gear, take my time and do one pass perfect, yeah. One pass perfect home.
I just folded this back, now I can actually see.
Yeah, definitely ditching that windshield was the way to go.
Thank you.
All right, so these tracks really kind of redeemed themselves here. In the beginning of this video, I kind of showed what they're not good at. Up in this deep snow, this it works. I mean, I just towed something uphill, and you know, we came thousands of feet up in elevation, and it's moving, it's going. Hanging with this thing here. Yeah. Hanging with this guy here.
Probably the other side on the way back.
Yeah.